Hello students, welcome back to the class. So we are going forward for a new short answers. We will discuss about unit 1 intermediate second year. Okay, so in this point short answers we will try to cover, okay, three short answers. So first one is called Minto-Morley Reform Act, we will cover it. You can find this all short answers in unit 1, okay, unit 1 second year. You can find the short answers. First one is Minto-Morley Reform Act, and then you can find Constituent Assembly, and then we can find Drafting Committee. What is meant by Drafting Committee? Okay, now we'll go forward here. First one we'll discuss about Minto-Morley Reform Act. Children, this act was passed in 1909. Okay, Minto-Morley Reform is nothing but an act. Okay, this act was formulated by two peoples. One is Minto and one is called as Morley, and that's why this act was got a name, Minto-Morley Reform Act. This act was formulated in 1909. So 1909 this act was formulated, so that's why they were called as Minto-Morley Reform Act. So we will discuss about this act, what are the important functions of the act, and when this act was passed, and what are the aims and powers and functions of this act. So first one, if you see that Minto-Morley Reform Act was implemented in 1909, and this act was formulated by two peoples. One is called Lord Minto and one is Lord Morley. Lord Minto is actually Viceroy. During that time he is the head of India. Viceroy is considered as a head of the India. So Lord Minto was a Viceroy and Morley was a Secretary of State. The second position after Viceroy, that is called as Secretary of State. So Lord Minto and Lord Morley, they formulated an act in 1909 and they named this act as Minto-Morley Reform Act, because this act was formulated by them, and that's why the act got its name, Minto-Morley Reform Act 1909. If you see that what are the important functions of this act, the important powers and functions of this act is, first one, what legislative council. The powers for the legislative councils, they wanted to increase powers of both central and state level. So legislative councils powers have increased at both central and state level. So the power of legislative council have increased at central and state level. Second thing, according to this act, they have provided separate electorates. Separate electorates were set up for the Muslim peoples. So according to this act, what they have did, they provided a separate electorate for the Muslims. Okay, during that time, Muslims considered as a minority section, so they demanded that some particular seats, whatever the seats are there, some seats should be reserved for them. Okay, if they wanted to represent the problem, if these seats are reserved, okay, whatever the particular seats are reserved at level, whatever the particular seats will be reserved, then in that seats minority representatives will be appointed, and if any minority representatives and leaders are appointed, they can take care of the minority easily. Okay, minority believe that if any minority leaders are appointed in the particular reserved seat, then they can able to protect their interest. So this is the main thing. So what we have understand here, two important functions are, one is, what is the legislative council? So legislative councils are set up at central and state level, central legislative council and state legislative council. So powers, increasing the power for legislative council. According to this act, the power of legislative council have increased. Today if you see, legislative councils are not there in any states. Only hardly 6 to 7 states we can find legislative councils in state level. Okay, in central level Rajya Sabha is considered as legislative council. So during that time legislative council power was very less. So here according to this act, they wanted to increase the power of legislative councils who are at central as well as state level. And next come to the point, they wanted to provide separate seats, separate electorate, the list of the voters. They wanted to provide a separate electorate for the minority. So during that time, the minority have demanded that some particular seats should be reserved for them. And in these particular seats, only the minority representatives will be appointed. If any minority representatives are appointed, then they can able to protect their interest easily. So this is the point. Next point is, if we are learning about Constituent Assembly. Constituent assemblies are mainly set up by the Britishers. So British government have set up the Constitution Assembly. So British government have set up this Constitution Assembly in 1946. So during 1946, the Britishers have set up the Constitution Assembly. The total members of Constitution Assembly is nearly 389 members were appointed, and these 389 members were appointed in Constitution Assembly. In this assembly, Dr. Rajendra Prasad was the chairman of Constituent Assembly. Who is the chairman? Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected as the chairman of Constituent Assembly. Later, he was considered as a president of India because he only acted as the chairman of Constitution Assembly, and that's why he knew the responsibility. And that's why after when the India got independence, Rajendra Prasad was elected as the first president of India. Okay. So Rajendra Prasad was elected as the chairman of Constituent Assembly, and our constitution, even Britishers also. Why this Constitution Assembly is important? Because Britishers also realized that they have to give independence to India. Okay, Britishers have understand, and Britishers has given advice to India that when we are going to declare independence, we are going to declare independence in the next year. Okay, Britishers are confirmed. And they asked and advised Indian people that they have to prepare the constitution. If India will get independent, they have to run the country. If they wanted to run the country, constitution is very, very important. And that's why Britishers only set up the Constitution Assembly. They supported India in preparing a constitution. So that after getting independence, if the Indian peoples will get independence, they have to run the country. And if they wanted to run the country smoothly, then constitution is very, very important. During that time, already they have one British constitution. But India is not willing to accept the British constitution, and that's why this has become must for the Indian people to set up the Constitution Assembly. So here, the first chairman of Constitution Assembly was Dr. Rajendra Prasad, and the first meeting was conducted and took place on 9 December. And this constitution was completed on 26 November 1949. The constitution was adopted. Means almost all the work of constitution preparation is completed, and this constitution was adopted to the constitution. The constitution was adopted by the assembly. Okay, after preparation of constitution, that constitution was adopted by assembly. But this later, this constitution came into force on 26 January 1950. Why 26 January we have constitution, we have released it during the 26 January? Why we have released? Because during that time, already the Indian leaders have decided that whenever India is going to declare independence, they will declare independence on Republic. They will declare full Republic, complete independence, they will declare on 26 January, Republic. Republic means complete independence. Because in 26, why they 1930 when the meeting was conducted in Lahore, before 1930 when they have conducted a meeting in which they decided that whenever if they wanted to declare independence, they will declare on 26 January only. Because during that time they have declared Purna Swaraj, they demanded Purna Swaraj. A meeting which was conducted in Lahore, in 1930 they have declared a Purna Swaraj, and that's why complete independence they have decided. That's why 26 January was declared as a Republic Day, because during that time two constitution also came into force, and 1930 they have decided that whenever if they wanted to release a constitution, they will release constitution on 26 January only. Third important question is drafting committee of constitution. Constitution Assembly was constituted nearly 7 members, which were called as drafting committee of the constitution. The 7 members of drafting committee was took place on 29th August 1947. So 29th August 1947, the responsibility was given to drafting committee. This drafting committee, they started copying the constitution from the various country. And the head of the drafting committee was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So leadership of drafting committee was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So later the drafting committee have completed its reports and given to the constitution, and constitution have adopted. Okay, 26 November 1949, the Constitution Assembly have adopted the constitution which was drafted by drafting committee. At last, to prepare a constitution, it have taken nearly 2 years, 11 months and 18 days to prepare the complete constitution. Once again, we'll go forward. So children, we have discussed three important short answers. First one, Minto Marley Reform Act. This act was formulated by Lord Minto and Lord Marley in 1909, and that's why this is called as Minto Marley Reform Act. According to this act, there are two important functions of Minto-Marley reform. First one, the power of legislative councils have greatly increased at central and state level. And second thing is, they provided, according to this act, separate electorates were provided for the minority. Because minority already demanded, since from 1907 onwards, the minority are demanding that some particular seats should be reserved for them, so that in that particular seats, if the minorities will be appointed, our minority leaders are appointed, they can able to protect their interest. Second thing we have discussed about Constitution Assembly. The Constitution Assembly was set up by the British government. So British government has set up the Constitution Assembly in 1946. So total members who were appointed in the Constitution Assembly were 389 members were appointed. During that time, 91 members were appointed, 92 members were appointed from princely states and some other members were appointed from British India. So totally if you see that 389 members were appointed from Constituent Assembly. And the chairman of Constituent Assembly during that time was Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was appointed as the chairman of Constituent Assembly. The first meeting was conducted for the Constituent Assembly 9 December 1949. So first meeting was conducted and next one 26 November 1946 the Constitution was adopted and 26 January 1950 the Constitution came into force. Next one, drafting committee. The Constitution Assembly have constituted 7 important members. These 7 members were called as drafting committee constitution. These 7 members leaders, the responsibility of the drafting committee leadership was given to Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar have drafted the constitution. At last the constitution was adopted on 1949. So to adopt, to prepare a constitution, it have taken nearly 2 years, 11 months, 18 days to prepare the constitution. At last the constitution came into force on 26 January 1950 the constitution was came into force. Okay, so here that when the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar have drafted a constitution, he have taken a constitution from the various countries, such as fundamental rights we have taken from America, fundamental duties we have taken from Russia, directive principles we have taken from the Ireland, parliamentary form of government we have taken from the Britishers. Like that we have taken the various concept of fundamental rights, we have taken a various concept of the constitution and we have prepared our own constitution. After that we have given approval to the Constitution Assembly. So drafting committee has given the approval and the constitution was approved on 26 November 1949 and the constitution came into force on 2 years, 11 months, 18 days. It have taken time. Okay. So children, this is the point we have discussed 3 short answers. In next class again we will go forward. We'll complete our remaining short answers.